Hello everyone. These set of lectures are going to be concerned with periodic structures. The lectures are part of the online course I'm presenting titled Dynamics of Structures. I'll just take a minute of your time to tell you why am I talking about periodic structures, why is it me that's presenting such a lecture. As a matter of fact, I've started working with periodic structures back in the year 2000 when I was a doctoral student in the University of Maryland under the supervision of Professor Amr Baz. During my studies as a PhD student, I performed several experiments on periodic structures in beams and plates. I've also been associated with experiments of periodic structures concerning bars and shafts. Since that time, I've published a few papers, more than 30, I believe, papers regarding periodic structures. However, I'm not anywhere near being the one who really established periodic structures. The concept of periodic structures was established back in the 1960s. Professor Mead of the University of Southampton, England, at that time, now in New Zealand, was the one who really introduced the topic with excessive mathematical analysis that reflected how much potential may be there in periodic structures. I don't want to take much more of your time introducing myself and the history of periodic structures, so I'll just jump into introducing periodic structures. But if you want more details, you may check the website Academy of Knowledge or the link below this video if you're watching it on YouTube. The link will take you to the page of periodic structures where you'll find some publications that may be useful for you if you are interested in further readings. What is periodic structures? That's the question that now we need to answer after that introduction I have presented. Well, the definition is quite simple. It's a structure that's composed of identical substructures. And these identical substructures are connected in a way that makes them repeated or appear repeated. Maybe if we looked at such a picture, now we can really understand what you're talking about. These railroads are supported every, say, what, half a meter maybe? I don't know the exact distance between those two supports, but they are repeated forever. Well, almost forever. This is a beam. The railroad itself can be seen as a beam. This beam structure has periodic supports. So now we can look at this as a periodic structure, since if we analyzed this part of the beam, the part that's between the two supports, we can see it as a repeated unit that's repeated for a long distance or a long time. Another example of periodic structures can be seen very clearly in such a set of solar panels. The solar panels are arranged in a manner that is repeated along the direction of the boom, or maybe you can even look at them as repeated cells even in the direction of the spaceship itself. However, we will be more concerned with the ones that are repeated several times, that's to say the ones that are in the direction of the boom. This is a two-dimensional periodic structure. Another type of periodic structures that we probably see every day is the repeated design in any multi-story building. Multi-story buildings generally have a repeated design, the repeated floors, the repeated stories. Probably the ground level and the top level are different, but between those two we have a repeated design. All the three that we've just seen are periodic structures. Now, if we get further, let's think about a wave propagating in a medium. Okay, that's probably a big jump from the definition of periodic structures to waves. Well, waves, we have them all the time. For example, this is a classical problem that we all have seen in our high school physics books. When light is incident on a surface, now this surface separates air from water. We know that part of the light will be transmitted into water, but with a refractive angle, so it will change the angle by which the angle it has with the normal axis, while some of the light will be reflected. This actually reflected part is the most important part that creates the phenomena we talk about when we are talking about periodic structures. Again, just to emphasize this, the reflected wave here is reflected as if it has a mirror, so the angles between the incident and reflected waves are the same with respect to the normal axis or the surface, and the part is transmitted. Now, if you imagine that the reflected part will travel on the same path of the incident light, what will happen? It will interfere with the incident light. Interference may produce a constructive interference or destructive interference. That's what stops light from propagating or increases some of the intensity of the light in the medium. Well, I'm not really interested in light. Probably most of us, including myself, who are interested more in mechanical vibration, we don't really understand much about the propagation of light and the physics of light. However, this concept of interference between the incident and the reflected wave is the main concept upon which the vibration of periodic structures is concerned. There are types of periodicity. They are all concerned with sudden change in the medium, just like what happened between air and water. A sudden change of the physics of the medium in which the light is traveling. Also, we may have similar sudden changes. For example, here at the boundaries between this part and that one, indicated by the red arrows, you can clearly see that there is an abrupt change in the geometry. The cell or the unit that we are concerned with may have also some abrupt changes in it or not. However, at the boundaries of the cells, that's where we are really interested to study what's happening between what's coming in and what's going out from that cell. So this first type of periodicity is what we may call geometric periodicity. Another type, which is exactly like what happened between water and air, is material periodicity. If the material for some reason is changed completely or partially, if I'm adding rubber, for example, on a shaft, then the overall performance of the cross-section of the shaft will change because of the existence of the rubber in that part. So we also consider this sudden change of material as periodicity, and in this case, a cell will be one that contains material A and material B together. So we study what happens in such a cell. Of course, the geometric and material periodicity may be mixed, introducing a more complex form of periodicity. However, for periodic analysis, this one won't make much difference, which introduces the word periodic analysis. Periodic analysis will be the subject of our next video. In this video, we just introduced what periodicity is, what is a periodic structure. We've seen some pictures of what we may consider periodic structures. And I also used some of your time to introduce myself, just to just for you to decide whether you should continue listening to these videos or not. So I hope that you will continue and that we will meet in the next video to talk about periodic analysis.